Finding parking in Philly is always a pain, and after I turn here, I actually saw an open spot I could have had if I just went straight. So pedal to the metal, the race was on to go back and get it. And this wasn't just any spot. It was next to a school, so that means during non-school hours, it's free, which is my favorite thing in the world. Not just because it saves me money and the stress of having to reload it every 2 hours, but most importantly, it prevents the Philadelphia Parking Authority from getting its greasy, slimy, dirty hands on my money. They are the absolute worst. I think Philadelphians would give up cheesesteaks if it meant the end of the PPA, but I digress. Anyway, for those that remember, if you hung out with Jimmy and I, this was actually the day of my first live stream. Thanks for coming out. And as per usual, driver Ed was running a little late, so the anxiety was high, and this spot was everything to me. So I had to whip around the block to get it, panic mode on full blast, and I got lucky. The spot was still there.
Let's go!
But now it's time for the dreaded parallel park. The camera doesn't do it justice, but this was gonna be a tight squeeze, but I'm a professional. Ain't no ride too big, ain't no spot too small to keep me from parking in you, babe.
Yikes, that was, oddly sexual.
And for the record, this millennial does not use cameras. I remember thinking I was all cool one day trying to teach my cousin how to parallel park, and he was like, why would I learn on your car? You don't have a camera, you loser. And it was in that moment I realized I was not as lit as I thought I was. Also, did I use lit correctly? It felt very awkward. Anyway, this is when I am reminded that there are two types of people in this world. The ones that entertain and ones that observe. Oh wait, no, that wasn't it. Sorry, being a millennial again. Hashtag free Britney. Let's try that again. There are two types of people in this world, and I had to choose which one I wanted to be. After all that struggle, the panic attack I almost had whipping around the block, the precision and concentration it took to nail this parking job, praying I don't turn this effort into a game of bumper cars with all these people around, the moment after all of that, this happened. Can you believe it? How you gonna do me dirty like that, girl? I was pissed. All that stress could have been avoided if she was just a little earlier, if I was a little later. And in that brief moment of self-sulking, that's when it hit me. I could either get upset about what could have been, or I could just be thankful that I got one of the best damn parking spots I could have asked for free. So the next time you find yourself getting frustrated over how things could have been, I hope you think of this video that could have very well been a lyric in an Alanis Morissette song. Take a step back and be thankful for what you have. Thanks for watching, guys.
It's a parallel park when you could have pulled in. Isn't it ironic?